Hello everyone, welcome to our presentation of paper toward constructing a compassion-based click model for web search. First, we introduce the outline of our paper. Most existing click models assume click on results only depends on the examination probability and the content of the result, but we guess that. Users may compare adjective results before click. So, we decided an iterating experiment to find how does user interact with the SERP. Through iterating examination, we found that user behavior is also influenced by the context of a result. Because of this, we designed a novel click model named Compassion-Based Click Model, CBCM for short. Finally, we test the CBCM by some experiment. The experiment results on a publicly available user behavior dataset demonstrated the effectiveness of CBCM. First, we introduce four problems of our iterating experiment. Research question 1. In a non-sequence revisit during the browsing process, are users more inclined to revisit recent results or not? Research question 2. Does user compare adjective results during the browsing process? Research question 3. During the user's browsing process, is the occurrence of non-sequence examination related to the result location? Research question 4. In a non-sequence visit, does the position bias exist? For the first question, we stressed that users may more likely to revisit results and were closer to the correct results and less screw up across the screens. We use the necessary screw up lines, in short, NSUL, to measure how users screw up. In a formula, we can find that if user exam results in order, the NSUL will be 0, otherwise it will be greater than 0. Compared to the revisit distance, NSUL can describe the user's screw-up behaviors more accurately. For example, if user exam results in SERP in order 15342, the max value of EI minus ED is 5 minus 2 equals 3. At the same time, the revisit distance may be 2. We compare the static of the user's necessary upward screen distance and the results are shown in figure. It can be seen that in more than 64% of the iTracking data, user exhibited a revisit behavior. In a revisit, more than half returned data to the nearest result. So, the answer to research question 1 is yes. For the research question 2, does user compare adjacent results during the browsing process? We investigated the physician times of user in different positions, and the results are shown in the figure. Most physicians occurred in high-ranking places. Next, we investigated the position of the first three examinations after the SERP is displayed, and we counted the number of times different combinations of the user's first three positions. The result is in the table. Outside exam by sequence, the frequency of 121 and 212 is very high. This shows that users may often compare results in top two positions. Therefore, the answer to research question 2 is also yes. For the research question 3, is the occurrence of non-sequence examination related to the result of location? This question tries to understand whether users have the same revisit probability when browsing the entry page during the browsing process. In order to study this problem, we compute the statistics on the probability of the user's revisits after examining results in different positions. These results are shown in figure. It shows that how often user revisits the previous results after fixing on a different position. The result is that users have a higher probability to revisit a result after examining a high-ranking position or when ranked on position 8. The occurrence of non-sequence examination is related to the result location. Finally, for the research question 4, we want to know that in non-sequence revisit, does the position bias exist? To investigate this issue, we conduct a study on the clicks of users during scrolling up during search. We define the process of scrolling up if and only if the user's most recent exam was the result before the return visit. For the logs of NSURL less or equal to 3, we counted the clicks during the scrolling up process. Considering that the user's verification process generally occurs from up to down with comparison on a small scale, we assume that there was a window for the user. As shown in table, we found that users were more inclined to click on the results that were more advanced in the scoring process of length 2 or 3. This reverted the position bias still exists and required consideration in the next step of this research. Therefore, the answer to the question is true. Now, we found that the answer of all four research questions are all yes, and then we will introduce how we design a click model to model our users' compare behaviors. In traditional user behavior models, we often use the examination hypothesis. It considers that click is only dependent by two random variables, EI for if user exam the result, and AI for that click is only on the result in and AI for is if the result is attractive. But didn't consider of the compare behavior. In CBCM, we define examination hypothesis proposed above as the weak order hypothesis. From a global perspective, user examine the results from top to bottom. From a local perspective, user compares two or three results simultaneously instead of judging only one result. We call these two or three results a WOE, Windows of Examination. A typical SERP page and a WOE, the first screen window presents three results after the user searched for the keyword WebCom 2021. We hypothesize that users examine them in a weak order. The user's WOE stays at the top two results at first and recognizes these two results at the same time. After checking the top two results, the user may or may not click. Then the user's WOE moves down, recognizes the second and third results, and the bias of whether the user clicks or not will be talked about later. This process can be widely described as WOE, move down. We join the results above and draw a process graph to describe user behavior. After a user enters the SERP, the user sets the WOE at the top two or top three results. Each time, a user may choose to click one result in the WOE or not. If a user clicks the one result and is satisfied with it, then they leave the page. Otherwise, the user returns back to the WOE in the SERP and continues to search. If the user chooses not to click any result in the WOE, they move down the WOE unless the WOE is already at the end of the SERP. In this case, the user leaves the SERP. Then, We give formulas based on comparison in this page. The first formula shows that the probability of users to click into some results is related to three elements. R is the relevance between the results and the query word. Gamma is the position of the result in the WOE. Theta is that if users have clicked the result, the distance of click again. The second formula shows that the probability of user to move down is related to element G, which will be different when position or number of results clicks before different. The last formula shows that the probability of user to continue to exam is depend on the satisfied probability of the result. Then we joined this formula together and can be written as formula in this page. And then we use SGD to train our model. The goal of train is to get a greater log likelihood. We also designed some experiment to compare our model with Mayo's train click models. We choose some stronger baselines of our models, and we aim to answer the following two questions by experiment conducted on a large-scale search log data set. First question, does CBCM perform better than other models in terms of click prohibition? And question two, is our model better than others in terms of relevance estimation? Our data set is randomly sampled from a search log in September 2017. We collected the search log data for 7 days. A detail about the data set can be found in this table. As in previous work, we select average perplexity and the log likelihood to evaluate the performance of click predictions. We tested the result of each model on the dataset and shown in the table of right. CBCM performs better on click predictions than other models and computing the log likelihood promotion. An important goal of the proposed CBCM is to improve the search ranking of web search engines. To measure the effectiveness of a click model on relevance estimation, the often used metrics include NDCG and MRR. The NDCG results obtained and shown in table on right. We can observe from table that CBCM achieves the best performance in terms of NDCG at 1 and at 3 and MRR. In summary, in terms of relevance estimation, our model CBCM achieves better performance compared to the state of the art click models. In this paper, we conduct a lab-based eye tracking study to show investigate fine-grained examination behavior of search users. Through eye tracking data, we find that users' performance accommodation strangers to examination search results. Although user examination search results following a top-to-bottom pattern, but they often see compare adjacent results, especially results at the top position. Based on these observations, we proposed a hypothesis called weak sequence or weak order and assigned a novel click model named CBCM, which takes the context of a result into consideration. Through extension experiment, we did not estimate that in terms of behavior prediction and the result ranking, CBCM significantly outperforms of the state of art based baseline models. In the future, we plan to further explore the factors and affect users' comparison behaviors and propose the more sophisticated models. That is all for my presentation. Thank you.